Hello and welcome back to the NBC Movie of the Week, Alan Wake.
Previously on Alan Wake, Alice has been kidnapped.
Alan, please help me.
Alice?
You'll know exactly what I say if you ever want to see your wife.
I can't tell anyone except my agent, Barry.
Damn it, Barry, they'll kill her. You're my best friend, and I'm worried that you're not right in the head.
The ransom is a manuscript I supposedly wrote that's coming true before my eyes.
It happened just the way it was on that page. So dark.
I have found only a few scattered pages.
I want the entire manuscript.
The deadline is in 2 days.
I found
Episode 3, Ransom.
How the hell did she get her hands on the manuscript anyway?
I don't know. She's resourceful. I told you were too hard on her.
Listen, I found out all sorts of interesting stuff while I was digging around.
Yeah.
Mr. Wake, it's Sheriff Breaker. We have an FBI agent here, Agent Nightingale.
FBI?
He's anxious to see you. You'd better come to the station.
Okay, I'll be right over, Sheriff. Let's make this quick, huh?
Help you folks? Name's Randolph. I'm the manager.
We're looking for Rose. Works as a waitress down at the diner.
Rose, sure. Nice girl. Who wants to know?
I'm Alan Wake.
The writer, huh? I heard on the radio you were visiting. Well, I'll show you her trailer. That Rose, she's a nice girl. Always pays her rent on time.
As I was saying, Al, I found all sorts of weird stuff from the local newspaper's archives. This place is crazy. Disappearances, mysterious deaths, urban legends come true, and get this, most of this stuff takes place around Cauldron Lake.
Well, you ain't wrong, mister. The Indians thought the lake was a doorway to the underworld. I'm the God-fearing type myself. I don't hold with that sort of thing.
Yeah, okay. Anyway, there was an island there owned by a guy called Thomas Zane. Now, some of the articles I found about him make him out to be a famous writer, but I ran a bunch of searches, couldn't find a single thing he wrote. Zane was heavily into diving, so much so that the place came to be called Diver's Isle. But the volcano under the lake erupted in 1970, and Zane went down with the island.
Mm. Yeah, how about that? It was there in the morning, as if it had fallen from the sky. But it would take a tornado to lift something like that. We're damn lucky it didn't crush any of the trailers.
Because they want you to make sure you focus on that. Tonight, a McMillan and wife and son.
Better. A local girl, Barbara Jagger, drowned in Cauldron Lake just a week earlier. They were lovers.
Sure, Jagger's a local spook store. The scratching hag comes for you in the dark. Childish stuff like that.
Hmm.
Anyway, Al, I'm just getting to the best part. All of the articles about this stuff were written by Cynthia Weaver. I asked around, and she's that crazy bag lady you met.
What, the lamp lady? She can be a little loopy, but she's not homeless or anything.
Yeah, anyway, she knew both Jagger and Zane before they both died, and she had some kind of a breakdown.
Dude must have CP.
Well, mister, this here's Rose's trailer. You mind me asking what you want with her?
We're just here to talk to her, pal.
We just want some information, that's all.
Oh dear, Mr. Wake, I'm so glad you're here.
Rose, you have my manuscript?
Oh yes. Yes. Please, come in.
Child, you don't look right.
Hey, this is really good.
Rose.
Yes.
My manuscript. I really need it.
I understand. I know what you need. I'm used to inspiring you.
Oh, for Barry? She doesn't have anything.
Yeah. Hey, Al. Al, what's...
Barry! What?
I spiked a coffee. It has aspartame.
It's coming for you, hiding in my barber's skin. I'm too weak to stop it. You must turn the lights on.
I promised I'd come visit you and your lovely wife. We must finish what you started. I insist.
You must turn the lights on.
Okay. If I were to ever work this hard on a book, yeah, it's time for me to
nauseous,
stop.
Hungover. Only anger kept me going.
Yeah, that's real, all right.
I can't tell reality from dream anymore, but it seems I have an imaginary editor to help me. She's an old woman in a funeral dress. I call her Barbara Jagger. She's very strict. I'm writing faster and faster. My manuscript is being heavily revised. The edits are getting very aggressive, and each day there's less of me and more of her. I hate it, but I know she's right. She promises me I can save Alice this way. She knows more of this than I do, about the complex incantation I'm attempting, about this place. She's worked with another writer under similar circumstances, Thomas Zane. The genre of the story seems to be shifting. It's turning into a horror story.
And I hate it.
I'm getting close. I can feel it.
Oh, I hate people. I hate it when people just do that. Turn something that you originally made and just...
I had less than 12 hours left to meet the kidnapper. All I could do was get Barry into the car, work something out once I got on the road.
Turn something less than, you know, what should be yours, but,
Welcome to the Oh Dear Diner. What can I get you today? Coffee?
I couldn't look up much hate for Rose. Something had used her to get to me, and left its mark.
First refill is free. Milk and sugar on the counter there. Would you like to hear today's specials? Thank you. A nice day. Come back soon.
Barry was out of it. He was way too heavy to carry.
No shit!
I deserve more money. I'm so handsome.
Sleep it off, pal. Sleep it off. I'll be right back. What the fu- She must be my biggest fan. I'm getting the fuck up out of here.
My gun and flashlight were gone. I'd have to find a way to get Barry into the car as quickly as possible. There was no time to waste. Mr. Randolph liked Rose. That little smile she had. How she was still sweet when life had tried so hard to make her bitter. It wasn't any of his business what she did in her trailer. But those strangers, the writer and his smart-ass sidekick, looked like trouble. And they'd been in there for hours, way past her normal bedtime. He reached for the phone and called the sheriff's station.
outside to catch a breath of fresh air. Let me tell you, the weather's getting heavy. Nights like this make me especially glad I'm here talking to you and not home in bed. Once the weather takes a turn like this, I can't sleep at all. It's all tangled bed sheets and dark thoughts, punctuated by the occasional plunge into nightmare. Is it just me? Well, perhaps it is. But I hope I can make the night a little bit easier to get through. Caller, you're on KBF FM.
Hey, it's Walt Snyder.
What's on your mind, Walt? You sound like a man with a problem, Walt. Outside looking up at the sky above our broadcast tower, thinking the same thing. What are you waiting for, Walt?
You're listening to 94.7, The Wave. Gotta love the ambiance. I hate the ambiance. And one has to wonder, where the hell's that car? You're listening to Twin Peaks Fire Walk with Me on 94.7 The Wave. Smooth jazz. I tell you, I am one with listening to smooth jazz because, well, my dad. Of course, he has a first name. His name was Bill. He listened to a lot of jazz, mainly something like Al Green. And, you know, since I was a kid, you know, most times when I was around him, he was smoking and drinking. You know, basically cigarettes and beer. That sort of thing. And for what it was worth, you know, I didn't mind the time I spent with him. I kind of wish I spent more time with him, and things would have been a bit different, but, you know, it is what it is. So, he usually listened to something like Al Green. So, you know, over the years, I started developing a taste for, you know, music appreciation.
get it now.
What? What'd I do?
God knows what you've done to that poor girl. This is Agent Nightingale, FBI. Get him up, Hemingway. You're under arrest. You move a muscle, I'll unload right in your goddamn face. Stay right where you are, Billy.
Toho, bullet time, dung gun.
What are you? I'm standing right here, you goddamn maniac.
I hated to leave Barry behind, but there was no way I'd miss my appointment with the kidnapper.
Let me just run from the police, yeah. Seriously. On what charge, sir? Shit. Sure, we're not running from zombies. We're not running from, you know, the undead. No, we're running from the goddamn police.
For decades, the darkness that wore Barbara Jagger's skin slept fitfully in the dark place that was its home and prison. It was hungry and in pain. It dreamed of its nights of glory when the poet's writing had called it from the depths and given it a brief, terrible taste of power and freedom. The rock stars had stirred it from the deep sleep the poet had sunk it back to in the end. When it sensed the writer and the fairy, it opened its eyes.
Now flare guns. Because, of course, why not? I mean, ever since I've listened to Persona, it just brought back memories of listening to smooth jazz. Yes, now you believe that something wrong is happening.
This horror was everywhere I went, circling me. The cops didn't stand a chance. They were after a writer, not a monster.
Out of all the stupidity, we're actually doing something that makes sense, just running away from the cops. Just like in California. Son of a bitch. Saying that's our bitch. That's our meal ticket, not yours. Think at this rate, oh, I need a weapon. No, I don't.
This is Jane. Mulligan, Thornton, come in. Over.
Thornton here. Jane, we got both Wheeler and Rose in custody. They didn't put up a fight or anything. My name is... Hey, what you... Come on.
Sit down and give me that.
Jane.
I got him, Mulligan. Mulligan. Over.
Wheeler's drunk or hopped up on something. Speaking of which, that fed had a pretty distinctive whiff of load of scotch about his name. Over.
He was drunk off his ass. Over.
I don't have anything on that, Deputy Mulligan. Over.
Well, whatever. Anyway, Rose is just being plain weird here. You better get Doc in and take a look at both.
Over.
Gotcha. You better get them here quickly. The, Fed's gonna wanna interview Wheeler, over.
Oh yeah, I bet he does. Looks like they have a lot in common. Mulligan out.
Ah yes, the police always doing their job, wherever the hell that is.
I can see the lights at the radio station in the distance.
Oh, that. If you're telling me that is my next checkpoint, you must be out your gut. Thank you. Never asked for this, never wanted it. I just wanted to find my wife.
I imagine that the broadcast tower in the distance was part of the local radio station. Man seemed like a decent guy. Perhaps he could give me directions to the coal mine.
Maybe. Probably get me a few weapons too.
Unnatural shadows clung to the gate. The darkness that was after me was trying to stop me. I wouldn't get through without one.
However, I do not have a weapon of choice. And I truly and utterly need one.
There was no power to the searchlight.
However, I looked for a gun. I never found one. And I thought to myself, oh shit. And then it dawned on me. And then that's when I learned how to be resourceful.
The old generator packed out. I'd have to see if I could fix it and try again.
Not without a shot of coffee first. This is becoming a chore. This is becoming a chore in which I gotta keep this son of a bitchin' thing on. Break this son of a bitch down. And now reach the goddamn radio station. I sacrificed for my wife? Harry Mason he is not, nor is he James Sunderland. That's what we're up against, huh? Okay, game. Alright.
It took me a moment to recognize the flashbang grenades. They were an ideal weapon for my situation.
Oh, that's extremely powerful. Yes, about my situation is pretty goddamn severe, isn't it? Oh yeah, I'm running around with just flashbangs. You know, it's not a big deal, it's not a problem. Give me more bang for my buck, that's for damn sure.
And here's another call. You're on KBFFM with Pat Maine.
It's no Peabody, Pat.
What's on your mind, Bill?
Well, I live near the trailer park, Pat, and there's a big ruckus going on over there.
Yeah, that's just up the road from me, too. What's going on, do you know?
Oh yeah, I'm gonna be back all the way up from there. That's a checkpoint. That's on another page.
Paging Mr. Wake.
Touched by the dark presence, Rose was lost in a dreamland where everything was drawn in black and gray crayons. The old lady had promised her that all her wishes would come true. She would be Ellen Wake's muse. She was smiling so hard it hurt her face. She crushed a bottle full of sleeping pills into the coffee. Deep down inside, she was screaming in terror.
Oh, I bet she was. Do you think now I can, get some more flashbangs? No, son of a bitch! Okay, so I am going the right way, oddly enough. Hello, checkpoint. You are what the doctor ordered. You think now I can, you know... I'm glad to see you two flashbangs. Yay! Radio station! Flash grenade! I was right there too. Flash bomb! Thank you. Flash bomb! Can I get to the radio station one piece, please? Cracker! You said freeze, I said cracker.
I hope Maine could lend me a car to get to the coal mine.
That man must have heard it all. And he's getting very, very tired of being understanding. The Night Owl. The voice of Pat Mayne. All night, every night.
Mr. Wake.
Oh, I'm so glad you could find the time to do this, Mr. Wake.
Nowhere from now, Dan Brown. You got away from me.
Don't what?
Whoa. Everyone calm down. Put the gun down. We're all friends here, right?
Cool your jets, Nightingale. We got him. What the hell's the matter with you? There's a civilian in there.
There was a civilian in there, and there was Alan Wake, and in which he ran the hell up out of here. We could talk this out, Alan.
Yet, even if it kills me, you hear me? You hear me, H.P. Lovecraft?
Excuse me, sir.
I've been off so many cliffs, it was ridiculous. That's what you get for naming a book The Sudden Stop. It was probably good I hadn't had the chance to tell Maine where I was going. I'd have to lose the cops and find my own way to the mine.
I was gonna ask, but, this son of a bitch is asking for, I don't know, a Shoryuken to the nuts.
Nightingale stared through the broken studio window into the dark woods. He turned around, started to walk out, but Maine grabbed his arm. Young man, you almost shot me. You don't shoot off rounds at people like that. What's the matter with you? Nightingale shook his arm free, marched out. His cheeks burned with rage and humiliation.
Well, of course he would be. The boy ain't thinking. I'm doing all this just to reach a goddamn train depot. For fuck's sake, here.
Thank you.
Oh, thank God, I finally got a weapon. Because you can only go so far with flashbangs. You gotta have something more!
There was no sensible reason for the power company Lucrex to be here. It was to anticipate that a light for someone like me to use.
There we go. Because if I'm going to be going through this, man, it- Thank you. Oh, that stinks.
Sensible reason for the power company work lights to be here. It was almost as if they'd been left for someone like me to use.
Finally. sorry if the light is just beaming in my face like that, but god damn, that was necessary. Well, not really, but you get what I mean. Bitch. The darkness controls the taking. Yeah, tell me about it. Sarah distrusts Nightingale.
Sarah trusted her gut, and her gut said Agent Nightingale was an asshole.
Oh, shit.
He felt wrong, and it wasn't just the smell of stale booze. It was in the way he flashed his badge, pulled rank, the look in his eyes when he wanted answers. Where was Ellen Wake? What was this about an accident? Where was his wife? And most importantly, why did she let Wake go? He wouldn't answer her questions. Federal business was all he'd say.
Thank you. Hello?
The most stubborn man I've ever met.
Alice?
Alan. I'm so afraid. It keeps me in the dark. Please help me. I look at you, Alan, and it's not you. It's something else. Looking out from behind your eyes.
Alice, I'm here.
Damn Wi-Fi.
The connection had been terrible, but that wasn't the only thing that hadn't been right with the call. She sounded wrong somehow, but she had called me.
But wouldn't that be a good thing if she did call you?
The pipe wrenched itself loose from the bridge's steel framework. Wrapped in darkness, it floated in midair, twitching. For a moment, I didn't understand what I was looking at. The heavy object lurched at me with impossible force. I threw myself out of the way, but just barely. When I turned my flashlight on it, it shook in a dark rage before it flew at me again.
The thing I saw, it was a mimic.
I could see a railway bridge up ahead and a warehouse of some sort on the opposite shore. I hoped I could find a car from there.
Boy, that's some checkpoint. Follow up here, okay. I know his feet must be tired. Shit. His feet will be telling the story here.
That was pursuing me was growing stronger.
Okay.
And it was taking over everything in its path.
Okay, let's climb.
That was pursuing me was growing stronger, and it was taking over everything in its path.
Gotcha, crap. What the hell am I playing? Ultima now?
The darkness that was pursuing me was growing stronger. And it was taking over everything.
Ah! told me, oh, go up.
That was pursuing you was growing stronger, and it was taking over everything in its path.
I'm dealing with a character who is too realistic for his own good.
The darkness that was pursuing me was growing stronger, and it was taking over everything. Are we done here? This irritates me. Thank you.
Oh, really? We're going through this kind of shit? Poltergeist? A reminder, you're talking to someone who has experienced death a lot in his life, to where it's just annoying.
I slammed the door shut right in his smug face. He pleaded for me to open the door. True to form, the asshole actually thought I would obey. I had no sympathy left, no guilt either, not for him. I took a moment to savor the scream. I bet I had a smile on my face. It was all that I had time for. The dark presence was inside the lodge with me.
And I simply told him to go fuck off.
As a teenager, just starting to get interested in writing, Stephen King had been a source of inspiration to me. I thought about all the inanimate objects that had come to life in his books. No one is safe in a good horror story. Certainly not the protagonist.
That's
what makes them fun. This was anything but. The darkness could possess anything, and it was getting closer.
Yeah, this'll work. Oh yeah, this'll totally work.
Find a vehicle.
You can't hurt him.
No! I never realized that.
You wonder why I never do horror games? Because they would irritate the fuck out of me.
For granted, unaware that they are merely a thin veneer of desperate self-delusion, covering a vast cosmos of madness and horror. All too often, the stars are right. In Night Springs. Tonight's episode, A Family Occasion. Journalist Alvin Derlis' trip to study the local customs of an insular community in Night Springs has been less than successful. Until tonight.
I'm glad you changed your minds about this. Ancient customs, the horror of old. I had to realize this kind of
Mr. Derleth, we don't want to feel like we're on exhibition.
What?
But you have demonstrated the seriousness of your intent.
Oh, I am serious. Really, just do your thing. Stay out of your way and observe.
Actually, I thought you could assist us. I'm afraid we are a man short. It would provide you with an intimate perspective.
I bet. Really? Of course. Nice to have you. Well, I guess that's the least I... What would I have to do?
Oh, here. Let me show you with a kiss.
Tales from the Dark Side. Tales from the Dark Side. Great episode. Now to watch Devil Man.
The darkness surged towards me, sucking everything loose from the ground into its depths, tugging at my clothes. I saw the flare the kidnapper had dropped and threw myself towards it just as I felt my feet leave the ground. The darkness embraced me with the force of a tornado. Somehow I managed to light the flare. The darkness roared and cast me away. I fell toward the dark waters of the lake far below.
And there I saw it plain as day, a piece of shit car. Never have I been so thrilled to see a piece of shit that actually works. As well as a thermos of coffee. I miss having my Godot blend number 999. Making doubly sure here. Because now, I just want to find a car. So I can get the hell out of Dodge. That's not the ride I was looking for. Son of a bitch. Let's get the hell up out of here!
I have never been this glad to see the sunrise. I had a couple of hours to get to the coal mine. The coal mine wasn't far now.
Of course it wasn't far. It took fucking forever. Shit.
Today, I would meet the kidnapper, and he would give me Alice. I wouldn't give him any other choice. A drowning man would clutch at a straw. Thank you.
Little by little, without realizing it, I'd come to believe that the story in the manuscript was coming true. The current of its narrative had taken me deeper and deeper into dark waters. Alice had been taken from me. Barry was probably in jail. I was a fugitive from the FBI. The whole world taken over by the dark presence was trying to destroy me. It all felt real, but it matched a textbook case of insanity.
Of course it'd be a textbook case of insanity. You will never, ever see a vacation like this ever again. Should never have HP. Because the system itself would just so take advantage of fucking up your ride as soon as you get one. This is a very unsafe road, mind you. So therefore, yeah, no. I'd be cautious on a road like this. Here we are at the coal mine.
I was early. I was supposed to meet the kidnapper at noon in the main building. The coal mine was quiet. It was a museum now.
This was some checkpoint, man. Wait.
With Nightingale gone and the night wind blowing in through the broken studio window, Maine stared at Sarah. The sheriff looked away. Maine's voice shook with barely controlled anger. That boy's doing more drinking than thinking. I hope you know what you're doing, Sarah. He's got a sickness in his eyes. You take my word for it. He wants to wait for a reason, and it's not for anything good.
course is not for anything good. In 1970, a volcanic eruption below Cauldron Lake, while relatively minor, caused most of the deep mining tunnels to collapse or flood. 32 miners lost their lives in the calamity. All in all, mining around Bright Falls came to a final stop. Now many of the remaining buildings are protected as historical landmarks.
I didn't want to go outside. Cops had to be looking for me. The noon sun turned the place into a sauna. The day dragged on. Different scenarios ran through my mind. Ways of how I tortured the kidnapper to get Alice back. Or the different horrible things he could have done to her. I imagined her dead. I had no way of knowing she was still alive. It was killing me. I was running on blind hope. It was all a waste of time. The bastard never showed up.
I began to snap. Hard.
Wake! Where the hell are you?
Change of plans. You know where Mirror Peak is? It's a big mountain north of where you are. You follow the path from the mine, you can't miss it. There's a lookout point there. I'll be waiting.
I'm through being jerked around by you.
You want to see your wife alive? Because if you do, you'd better watch what you say to me. Do we understand each other?
I want to talk to Alice.
Yeah, I want the manuscript. Don't keep me waiting, Wake.
Hello? Hello? I'm gonna kill him. I had to get to Mirror Peak.
It was close, maybe closer than ever before.
Caution my ass. Leave the building. Okay, how? Okay, so how the hell am I supposed to leave the building? Reach the lookout. Look out.
When Thomas Zane fell for Barbara Jagger, it happened fast. She was young, vibrant, and beautiful, full of life. He had never been a very happy man, and without any seeming effort, she had changed all that. Zane felt good for the first time in his life. Everything she did was another piece of a jigsaw puzzle he hadn't even known he'd been missing. And best of all, she made the words flow, strong and sharp. She was his muse.
Thank you. This is becoming cheap beyond all level of cheap. Six gun scribe. A moment to breathe. Are we done here? Just a little more.
Thank you.
would you open that? Done in there. Alright, now, okay then, I don't know what the fuck that was, but I don't like that.
The only way to reach the hillside ahead was to go through the building. I had to find a way to avoid electrocution.
I'm gonna have to use this shit like it's Jurassic Park. Think I'm gonna get scared by this shit? Nope. I'd rather be pissed off more than be scared. What the fuck? Ah! Thank you. sound and fury. Are we done here, folks? Are we done here? Real sicky shit, gang. I'm not even going to say anything as far as say, give me a surplus of items. Give me a box of ammo, please. Die. listen. I'm getting real tired of your shit. Been tired of your shit. Trust no one in the dark. No! Thanks for making this so goddamn obvious. Follow. Give.
Some of the Taken retained echoes of their former selves, but these were just the nerve twitches of a dead thing. Nothing remained but a shell covered and filled with darkness. In most cases, these puppets were enough for the purposes of the dark presence. But for anything more elaborate, as with the writer, it was different. It needed his mind. And so rather than taking him over completely, it merely touched him.
In a way that I never did. Give.
There was no way the flashbang grenades were standard power company equipment.
Oh no, these things were powerful. And I was grateful for seeing them because I was getting pissed off. Get out of here. You too. The rainbow jackass.
Thank you.
crosswing! Flashbang! Thunder and lightning! Thank you. Head to the light. That way. Thank you. Well, of course it would be like that. Why wouldn't it be? You know what? Screw it. Dang. Not like that. I did all this for a cup of coffee. Ow. It was
was worth it. The coffee was definitely worth the headache. Ow.
And so is the light. Thank you.
I had nearly a plan. I was going to give the kidnapper all the manuscript pages I had for Alice. If that wasn't enough, I'd hold him at gunpoint and make him talk.
Fuck yeah!
I had nearly a plan. I was going to give the kidnapper all the manuscript pages I had for Alice. If that wasn't enough, I'd hold him at gunpoint and make him talk.
And that's why I decided, why stop there?
Thank you.
gonna tell each of them to go fuck off. Before I knew it, I got blindsided.
I had no real plan. I was going to give the kidnapper all the manuscript pages I had for Alice. If that wasn't enough, I'd hold him at gunpoint and make him talk.
Worked great in my head. You know, having, you know, little to no plan is seemingly better than just having you. Shit. Having some kind of plan is better than having no plan at all.
I had no real plan. I was going to give the kidnapper all the manuscript pages I had for Alice.
Of course.
If that wasn't enough, I'd hold him at gunpoint and make him talk.
Because I know I'm right there.
going to give the kidnapper all the manuscript pages I had for Alice. If that wasn't enough, I'd hold him at gunpoint and make him talk.
That was my actual plan, just holding the fort down.
Was moving ahead of me in the same direction I was going. A cold feeling settled itself in the pit of my stomach. Was it going for Alice?
And if so, why?
Yeah.
The place was dead, a ghost town. Had been for decades, maybe a century.
You're telling me? Sheesh.
Things were never as simple in real life as in fiction.
Are they ever?
I'd lost count of the times I had wished there'd be a clear reason for my writer's block.
Me too.
Something to fight. Something to lash out on. There wasn't. I was filled with doubt. I was nothing like the hero in my books. Alex Casey had gone through his life with single-minded determination, never wavering from his goal. Even now, I was angry at myself. Angry at Alice. Angry at Barry. I was fumbling and I had no plan.
I have no mouth, and I must scream. Great Peak Gorge. Originally founded in 1928, the Great Peak Gorge mining town was one of the permanent settlements the Bright Falls Mining Company built for its workers. The nearby graveyard is a testament to the dangers miners face on a daily basis. Most of the men who lost their lives over the years here were buried there, a grim reminder to be careful for those who remained. Great Peak Gorge was abandoned almost overnight when the Bright Falls Mining Company closed its doors in 1970. Lovely. Thanks, Checkpoint. Love you too. Iron Horse. Hi, I beat Steam. Well, found the key. Key to what, though? And what does this mean?
Anything outside of riding is a struggle. I feel ill. I managed to make my way downstairs. There's a shoebox filled with books and papers by Thomas Zane. It's very hard to focus, but I managed to read some of it. He's a poet, and a good one. He writes of muses and creators summoning fabulous things from the magic lake, using his powers to shape the world of a realm of gods and dreams and demons, dark things that wait for a chance to slip through, wearing the flesh of men as disguise. Zane writes about himself, his girlfriend being taken over by a dark presence, about growing scared of the lake. Zane believes it's a mirror to the gaping void of darkness above, where some Lovecraftian presence lurks. I crawl back upstairs. I'll borrow these things for my story. They ring true. They fit.
Yeah, you definitely need to get yourself away from this place. What possessed you to do a game like this? No. Not a damn thing possessed me to do a game like this.
The kidnapper had sent me a text. The message was full of spelling errors and insults. He was telling me to hurry up.
I'm getting angry. Wake, I'm getting angry. Hurry the fuck up. You got him, birds! you ever had a day like this, I feel for you. So, how do I get out of mine? And I'm not gonna say, join me next time! No. I really would like to know how to get out of this mine. Never mind. What?
Even behind the closed doors and curtains of his grimy room at the Majestic, the local motel, Nightingale could feel the locals' eyes on him, the unrelenting pressure of their judgment. He forced it out of his mind. For all he knew, they could all be under Wake's spell already. You do what you have to do to get the job done. He took comfort from the bottle in his hand. Please, he thought. Just let me get through this.
Let it be, good shit. Did you lose this? Yeah, it's my marbles.
To make my way up this mine shaft in order to go on. Maybe the machinery could help me with that.
Still?
Yeah.
Yes, I am actually scared at this point. I'm for using most, if not all, my focus just to get to pass here. Thank you, sweet, sweet, sweet save point. One clip, that's not good.
Lightning flashed behind the windows of Calder Lake Lodge. Tor Anderson laughed and held the steel hammer above his head. Nurse Sinclair was trying to calm him down without success. Tor grinned madly and shouted, "My hammer's up. Here's a friendly poke from Molnir, wench." He brought the hammer down with all his might on Sinclair's head. "We're on a comeback tour, baby."
You got to be fucking kidding me. The hell is this cliffhanger? Shit. Damn, you would be thinking it's Ninja Gaiden. It's gonna get worse before it gets better. I can already feel it. Fucking knew it! Get me there, thank you. Seriously, shit. At least I can raid the clips. Thank you. is irritating me. Like, passive mere irritation, this is super irritation. In this case, just like, nope. Anger be my strength. Anger be my strength. Anger be my strength.
Maud had checked all of Stucky's rental cabins. There had been no sign of the Wakes. It was dark when he'd found their car parked at the end of the road by Calder Lake. It made no sense. They must have taken a wrong turn, but there was no sign of them, and the car had been there for hours already. Frustrated, Maud stood on the rotten ruin of the footbridge that had once led to Diver's Isle before it sank beneath the waves years ago. The boss wouldn't be happy.
Across the mountain rooms. Okay, how? without actively trying to kill myself in the process of crossing these godforsaken ruins. That's what normally I do when I don't know a place very well. Because since I use a map, I usually backtrack to a place like a checkpoint. That's how I got to, that's what I had to do when I had that meet and greet. To back up a bit, do something like this, and oh hey look, it's Resident Evil. Yes, all those years I've been playing RPGs, yeah, they paid off. By going to a place I've never been to before. Get myself lost in the process, and still having enough battery power to get me through the entirety of the episode. Miss you, Tom. Did you write this? Tom. Tom, You talk to me on TV. This is a checkpoint. Wait. That does it. Did all this just to...
I could see Cauldron Lake. I thought I could make out the spot where the island and the cabin had been. There was a light near it. It had to be a boat.
And to my surprise, I'm gonna need a bigger boat.
I was close now. I had to get there fast. I dreaded what I would find. I tried to hold on to Alice, but her food melted away. I was losing control. Dr. Hartman stood in her place. I wanted to hit him, but my arms were jelly. He smiled. It was a reassuring smile, and I hated him for it. I had to give you a sedative. Don't fight it. You went through another rough period. Right now, it's very important that you stay calm. We don't want you to have another episode. You're a patient at my clinic. Have been for a while now.
I'm here! I'm coming!
No! Get away! Sorry! Please, it's late! The boss didn't know who he was messing with! I didn't know! I swear, I didn't know! We don't have a wife! We don't know where she is! She's probably drowned! We just said we had her to make a play ball! You see? They get a lighting for us! Please!
Inside my mind sometimes. And that was chapter 3. End of episode 3.
I'm hunted by the law.
Sheriff, Wake's running. I'm getting chased.
Are you serious? seriously telling me that Ryder just took out my deputies?
A thriller I supposedly wrote is coming true. The genre of the story seems to be shifting. It's turning into a horror story. I was told that Alice had been kidnapped, but that was a lie.
We don't have his wife. We don't know where she is.
Her purported kidnapper was eaten up by the dark presence before it attacked me.
And next time, the truth. So, I'm actually going to stop here. And next time, we will do episode 4, The Truth. So stay tuned. More of Alan Wake right after this. Thanks so much for watching.